Chip. I'm your host, Nameshon. I'm here with Noxious and Raven, and we are ready with the first semifinal.
Yeah, we're all in black.
We are the casters band.
Yeah, like, I guess that's a bit generic, but I guess we'll go with it.
Yep. So the first semifinal that we are going to see is your teammate Noxious. It's SuperJJ.
Yeah.
Versus Legendaeren, who is
Legendaeren.
Your kind of former.
My ex-teammate. Yeah.
Ex-teammate. Yeah.
Your kind of former ex.
But this
teammate.
Is not nice. Nice save there.
You caught it. I was like, maybe you let it slide.
No, not once.
You got it. All right. So it's this time it's Complexity again versus not UK.
London Conspiracy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm still on Legendaeren's side.
All right. So you vouch for Legendaeren, you vouch for JJ.
Of course.
But like, honestly, guys, looking at this matchup, they're both playing Rogue. There are some differences. So Legendaeren is bringing Malaga's Warlock to the fold, and he's playing Secret Paladin, where JJ is playing Midrange Paladin, and he brought Druid. What do you think has an advantage?
Yeah.
If you put your like X's and...
I'd say, like, funny, I'd still say JJ just because of the fact, like, Rogue-wise, I feel like his experience will, you know, probably give him an edge overall. But even just matchup-wise, right, Malilock isn't necessarily a great matchup, but it's not a bad one either, because you can burst them down a lot more easily than when they put down giants and start taunting them up, right? Like, they don't have any of that massive wall of giants that you have to go through, so starting to burst them down early works very often. You can just start pushing, and unless there's heal bots suddenly coming out of nowhere, then usually you're able to put it. So I kind of feel like the Rogue alone from JJ will give him the end. Midrange Pally is also not too bad in that case.
And good versus versus Secret Paladin. So,
right.
So he has a couple of good matchups there.
Yeah, I think a lot of it as well as will rely on the first match and the actual class picks. Because if Super JJ locks in the Rogue and then Legendaeren can like snipe that deck straight away, then suddenly the matchups are, you know, a little bit better for him.
Yeah, I mean, if the Rogue loses from JJ, then he's going to mid-range Pally, then there's a Rogue from Legendaeren who can just farm that, right? And then the following deck from JJ is also not necessarily favored. So if his Rogue is knocked out early, and he's got to resort to the other decks to beat the Rogue, it almost feels like, again, the Rogue is going to be the deciding deck for either player, whichever one ends up sticking to it.
But we've
seen upsets.
There's one deck that we haven't talked about. There's the Druid from JJ.
Yeah.
And Druid should be okay versus Rogue.
It's all right. It can sometimes get pushed out, but yeah, it should have a decent matchup.
Yeah.
How about Druid versus Malygos Lock and Secret Paladin?
I think versus Malygos Lock, if the Druid can just get a bit of ramp early and play very aggressive, that's the way forward. But it's maybe the opposite of the way we saw the game versus Ness earlier on, where Ness was just too defensive. And whenever you give a deck like Malygos time, then it's going to just destroy you. That's the whole point. The deck's built to go late game, whereas Druid's much more mid-range. So I think that's okay. And then versus Secret Paladin, it's a tough one. You need to do Druid things to Secret Paladin to be able to win that game. Swipe's kind of important, but you just need to ramp and like beat them in the speed game and get a board before they just play Challenger and then win.
All right. So it seems like JJ really has a huge advantage versus Legendaeren at this point. Noxious, you mentioned that Rogue is going to be the key class. What does Legendaeren have to do to win versus JJ?
Secret Pally needs to sweep.
Can't he just sweep with Rogue as well? Just win the mirror match?
He could, if he wins the mirror match, but it has to be the opening. I mean, if I am Legendaeren, I think I'm opening with Rogue no matter what.
Yeah.
Because like the only bad matchup would be Druid, perhaps, and that even that is a far foregone conclusion. You can't really figure out whether or not Druid is going to lose, right? You can't make that conclusion right away. If you're JJ, you might be able to fight back, but I just feel like the Rogue is the best opener.
Well, I think the worst matchup is an okay matchup.
Then
in a pretty
fine.
Good position,
yeah,
right?
Like that's
in
last year standing as well. Like, you don't have to rely on your Secret Pally to win against mid-range Pally. Like, you don't have to go back to that day. If you can sweep, do it.
Yeah.
And sweeping a guy who's had as good results as JJ right now would basically give Legendaeren quite a bit of credit, I think.
I wonder what's the mindset of the players, because JJ really wanted to face Kalento before, and he won versus Kalento.
Yeah.
Maybe he's actually, like, right now facing Legendaeren, he feels like, hey, I just won versus Kalento, I can win versus anybody.
Oh, man.
So maybe he's not prepared versus Legendaeren mentally. And on the other hand, they're also playing for good money, because right now they're guaranteed 2,500, but the one who wins will end up in the final. So he is guaranteed $5,000.
Yeah.
And he has a chance to win 10,000.
Yeah, I mean, never mind the money. I feel like at this point, assuming JJ thinks, you know, he's overconfident, he's like, I just beat Kalento, I went 9-0 in the group stage. Assuming he's in that mindset, he still has to think, I want to beat whichever one of the other guys ends up in finals. Like, I want RDU to go there and crush him. And I want to do that after I beat Kalento earlier and crushed everyone in the group stage, just to show that, you know, the recent wins he's accumulated aren't flukes. Like, they're actually reflective of something. And the last hero standing format seems to work super well for him.
Yeah, and on Legendaeren's side as well, like, he's going to be really hungry for the big win, because he won earlier in the year in Gfinity, but there's been nothing else after that that's really, you know, continued. And like we've said multiple times, consistency is key in this game. That's what you need. Whereas SuperJJ, he's been on a bit of a hot streak. So, you know, both players just really, really want to take home the first place, actually. So, looking forward to see it.
And it's so interesting that both players actually come from the open qualifier. They weren't invited.
Right.
They just grinded it out from the very beginning. And they are here now facing each other.
RD is the only one, I think, that's left from the invitation, right? So, from all the invitees, RD is the only one left. And everyone else is a qualified player. So SuperJJ really had to fight his way through this. He said, if I can just get top four, like, the fact that I made it top 16 is already a victory. He told me that because of the amount of work he had to put into it just to get here. So I think the fact that he's in top four already, just no matter where he goes from here, he's satisfied.
As we were saying earlier about, you know, celebrating top eight, actually, it's another consistent finish for JJ. Just continuing off the back of the previous tournament wins.
All right, guys, we talk a lot about those players. Let's see what the players themselves have to say about us.
I'm feeling good, I'm just enjoying my time here. I came here through the last to the open qualifier, arrived at the first day. Now it's an amazing feeling for me. I made some mistakes yesterday. Today I played really well. I can't really expect to win every game, but I'm just trying to play my best and play my outs. It's like, Hearthstone is so hard, you can just lose against any player if there's just not the right RNG for you, or you are just tilting and making mistakes. Just take your time, improve class by class, deck by deck, hero by hero, and you just have to enjoy it a lot. Like, this is the most important part.
My name is Anton Danielsson. I go by the name of Legendaeren. I play for London Conspiracy, and I'm from Sweden. I think I played good overall. I've been here for 2 days now, and I've only lost one game. Now that I'm in the top 16, I feel good about it, and that was my goal. The last game was the most challenging, since I had to win it, otherwise I would go into a tiebreaker. My approach for tomorrow is the same as the last few games. I've had a lot of success with my lineup, so I think it's pretty good. I hope to get a good night's sleep and then just come back and win it.
And Insomnia, that does not happen.
Yeah, it doesn't sound right.
But you have to prepare for the match anyway, and it's going to be a great match. But Rogue versus Rogue, this might be the decider. What are the differences in the decks? We've seen from SuperJJ, he is running Sludge Belcher and Farseus. And you know, Noxious mentioned this is one of the best Rogue builds that we've seen so far.
Yeah, it's funny because the Tomb Pillager coming out, I was talking to JJ about it. I'm like, your deck doesn't play Tomb Pillager, right? It's notoriously absent because we've seen a lot of it in all the other Rogues. But he says the card is amazing, but it's not a fit for Rogue, for the oil yet, until the list has been refined to include something that maybe benefits from the Tomb Pillager. It gives you that extra tempo. The only thing that he likes about the Tomb Pillager is like the 5 damage it can deal, which is a huge chunk of health in a deck like Oil. But if you don't get the damage in, because 5 is, like, it sounds ridiculous, but 5 is better than the 4 from Shredder by quite a good margin sometimes when you can get repeated damage, but you have to get there. And that's kind of the issue he finds with the card, is that it's not yet in a build that's refined, and he's not willing to play it. And I know Legendaeren is not playing the heavy healing version of the Rogues.
Raven, do you have anything to add about his Rogue?
No, I mean, I'd just completely agree with what Nox has just said, actually. It's I think the Tomb Pillager's definitely got a spot, but again, it's just, I don't feel it's strong enough to just slot in a deck. It's not like dropping Dr. Boom in a deck and you know it's going to do some work, right?
Yeah.
But the first match is going to be JJ's Rogue, and Legendaeren actually open with Druid with Leper Gnome.
So if he thinks he's outclassed in the Rogue Mirror, then going for his next best deck is probably a wise idea, especially since it's the aggro Druid. So that's going to take SuperJJ right away, completely off guard. One of the things to keep in mind, though, is that Fel Reaver is not a card you really want to play.
I was convinced he's playing Secret Paladin, but apparently I kind of missed it.
I know SuperJJ is playing mid-range. Super Pally was the opponent from Legendaeren earlier.
Yeah. He probably was like just free-owing people before.
I told you, the Mali lock earlier that we saw was a 3-0. And yeah. The other deck that we saw from him was a Rogue at some other time, I think.
Exactly.
So we haven't really seen much from Legendaeren besides the Warlock and a tiny bit of Rogue.
So it changes a bit because this deck can actually beat Rogue. It's kind of like a face hunter. You can rush.
Easily.
Yeah.
And now the question is, do you go for the prep Eviscerate Edwin for a 6-6, which then means that if there's no coin keeper, you're in a great spot because you win. But if you do that, it's all in.
Probably just refresh your weapon.
I know. I'm just hoping to see some shenanigans.
Noxious Thieves.
If he
well,
didn't
if
have
he goes
coin,
for keeper,
go for
though,
it?
If there's a. Oh, never mind. I was going to say, if there's a coin keeper for 2 damage, that would have been an interesting turn for
he could deadly poison as well.
Yeah, just like.
It, so.
Yeah, if you don't expect a BGH since it's aggro druid, then that play would have been pretty cool.
I'm just looking at that Fell Reaver, and
I foresee a disaster. I can already feel the disaster.
You probably don't do it versus Rogue when Rogue has 7 cards, like 8 cards in hand. You can do it when they are struggling. It's like
there are 3 cards. They've already, you know, played most of their options that look like they are struggling for removal.
Yeah.
But if they're gonna go like backstab, SI, prep, eviscerate. Just quit.
You just have your deck. Or like backstab, play SI, whatever, whatever, and then prep Zap.
Yeah, just like prep Zap, kill coin, get it back. You want to play? No problem.
And the issue as well is like, there's not really many more Zap targets in the deck other than those Fell Reavers. Like,
That's true.
So there's quite serious that JJ will just not play a Zap unless it's on a Fell Reaver, and then the Fell Reaver just negated the whole game, really.
Yeah, right now Super Jade is thinking, how do I approach this Leper Gnome? Like, do I want to use my coin sprint? I'll be on 9 cards. I can then next turn go ahead and play, you know, refresh my dagger, maybe find a sap for that Fell Reaver. Maybe I want to go for the big Edwin play, which we've talked about as well. And based on this, it's looking like the Edwin play.
Yeah, it is dangerous, but...
Oh man, an 8-8.
It would work if there is no keeper, because this is an aggressive druid, so the only way to deal with this Edwin is keeper of the grove, but there is one. And let's watch JJ's reaction. He's like, yep, there was a keeper.
He can't be too upset with that, though, because it's super unlikely to see the keeper. But I think the idea is you go for that play. If he doesn't have keeper, you just win.
Yeah.
Right? Just straight away. So pretty reasonable. And the follow-up for the Sludge Belch is actually really nice, especially as you've just seen the keeper.
Yeah. You have to trade with the Leper Gnome, right? Or do you just attack face and push?
Right.
The fact that he went all in, I think, is descriptive of just wanting to go face. Plus, he's got the Flurry.
Yeah, yeah. He has Blade Flurry, so he can afford to do that.
And second Deadly Poison, so this is so much damage coming from him.
Yeah, you wouldn't really think so, right? In a position like this. But I feel like Legendaeren with the swipe... It's a really solid swipe he's getting.
Would you actually hero power, coin out hero power?
I would,
well?
Yeah.
I think that's he gets the most, it feels bad to just coin hero power to finish off the Belcher, but you get the most value out of it, really, don't you? Because anything after that, coin just suddenly didn't do too much going forward.
Can't you just slam Fell Reaver here? Because there's only 3 cards and you've seen preparations and shenanigans.
I feel like Fell Reaver is a no-go in this matchup.
Yeah,
unless you're absolutely certain there's nothing else. Because the thing is, as long as you have swipes, Force of Nature, Druid of the Claw to charge, Druid of the Saber you could find, anything that can just rush the Rogue down instead of giving her time to react, that's what you play.
This Van Cleave somehow still surviving on the board.
Yeah, it doesn't look like much, but this Van Cleave has been packing a lot of damage, and now I wouldn't be surprised to see JJ use the attack phase, flurry, SI.
He could just deadly poison.
But that's losing a tiny bit of damage, isn't it?
It is, but then he is dealing a lot.
He's pushing, yeah, I guess.
Yeah, he is absolutely pushing. This is 14 points of damage right here. 10 from the Blade Flurry and...
Yeah, another...
And he has sprint on turn 7. It's perfect.
You're right. Yeah, never mind. I think at 9 health left, the druid force... A druid playing aggro and trading. Uh-oh, that's game. GG.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, though, would you not just taunt up Druid of the Claw? What's the one card you're afraid of?
Well, you win next turn, right? Lothlip.
What if you swipe the 3-3 and go face for 1? You're 1 off lethal afterwards. Is that just unthinkable?
I
feel like swiping face and attacking face with the hero power is okay.
Yeah, it is. Like, all those plays are okay. But I'm fine with charging phase as well.
That's right. Charging phase is all right. Yeah, might as well, because it plays a minion instead of giving it, like playing a spell. Yeah. The thing is, you can't use the hero power, so you're losing to Eviscerate if you don't kill the minions.
What's the worst that can happen?
Now, right now, nothing. After you kill the Edwin,
after the Edwin,
you're fine.
Come on, there's Lothar still.
Yeah, there's one card. There's also Farseer, which we haven't talked about.
Yeah.
He plays two. Oh.
Well, that's it. And this druid that we absolutely missed is actually killing Rogue, which was the most important deck.
Oh, the Lothar, the last card right there. And druids doing druid things. We'll
happy Feast of Winter's Veil.
Legendaeren must be really happy with this win, because for a lot of that match, it was not going his way.
Well, right. That's the really big thing you're worried about, is that you're going to be losing to that Rogue and having to
queue
the rest up.
Yeah, and then you're like, oh, against it again.
But still, really well played by JJ. The fact that he went aggressive, he went for the risky Edwin play.
I thought if he went for the risky Edwin, it was better one turn earlier. I'll be honest, I thought when he didn't pull a trigger on it as a 6-6, I'm surprised he suddenly opted for it one turn later.
Yeah, because in the matchup, the 6-6 is sort of the same as an 8-8, right?
Right.
Like, is the 2 damage going to change too much?
Right.
Whereas the turn earlier, well, you gain that damage back probably over the 2 turns anyway.
Yeah, and you could have killed the Leper Gnome one turn earlier.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just, it felt to me like he was trying to be conservative, and then suddenly he realized, I can't face tank this. I'm going to take, you know, another 4. That's too much against Druid. And then at that point, he went all in, like the biggest all in he could. And
to be honest, he knew what the card is, because he was able to draw one more card.
Oh, absolutely.
And decide after that. And now he's picking Midrange Paladin, which is a really good matchup versus this aggressive Druid. But aggressive Druid can do aggressive Druid things and just rush Paladin before he can stabilize.
But I feel like right now, Legendaeren's, you know, start, although it's good, with the double Aldor and the muster for battle, if Super JJ can find mid-game taunts, then I think he's going to be in a great spot. I think the Aldor's tempo is worth quite a bit here, unless you expect to... he's expecting to have to fight off that Jolir.
And the thing is, as well, Aldors are okay, because it's not like you're waiting to Aldor the Fel Reaver, because you have a quality. So you can deal with a Fel
Reaver.
So
good, right? So good.
Yeah, exactly. Because what you can do now, you can actually put it as a taunt as well to stop the minions. And there is that equality.
Yeah, the equality. Actually, he's not killing any 1-1s with that juggler hit. And the mid-game taunt that he absolutely needs to stall, it actually looks amazing for JJ here.
This is so huge.
Massive.
Without equality, it would be actually hard to deal with his minions, and he will consistently get damaged. But now he's just back, and he has Keeper on turn 4. So he can do whatever he wants.
If Shredder falls down, yeah, the Keeper trades. I was going to say, if Leper Gnome Hero Power kills the 1-1, there's no more Keeper, but right now, it's perfect.
Yeah.
All right, so Keeper for Super JJ. He has turn 5. He has quite a good turn 6 with Aldor and Cockhammer. You probably will be able to hit something with Aldor on turn 6.
For sure, yeah. And the one attack minion coming out here is the Dream. You just dodge a 3-2.
So for Legendaeren, you just have to play the minions, go for fate.
Yeah, there's not much else to do.
You have to already go all in. You have to wait and pick up an Innervate next turn, maybe pick up a Savage Roar afterwards and win.
Yeah.
And again, suddenly, thinking about the matchups about Fel Reaver, there's not a lot of matchups in the current sort of meta where Fel Reaver does a lot of work, especially if you look at Midrange Paladin.
Yeah.
He has Keeper of Alderman, 2 Aldors.
Secret, like Noble Sacrifice.
Yeah.
Like everything kind of...
Repentance, Double Beacon Hunter.
Yeah.
Speaking of the Devil.
Oh, hello.
You have to play it. I mean, you might not discard your entire deck, and as long as you don't, then the card discard is irrelevant.
Right? Aldor. It's just going to make it like, hello.
But then he top decks Keeper of the Grove and it's fine, right?
Not necessarily.
But it is kind of fine, though. But in this case...
There's a second Aldor.
Not so much. Right when you think you're done.
Oh, God. And this is like almost... This is worse than killing it for Legendaeren.
Oh, yeah. He'd rather lose it.
Yeah.
If you had a BGH here, that'd be nice. This Aldor, however...
The one attack's humiliating for the Fel Reaver. He can't go back home with one attack. Oh, no.
It's like, oh, Fel Reaver, they have time for coffee.
We have not seen a Savage Roar yet, though, so he might pick one up. No Keeper of the Grove either, for all that means.
Well, with Swipe at least, can kill the one token from Belcher.
Love the shield, and yeah, you see, I mean, look at the health of the Paladin, though. Like, we're talking about how good of a position JJ is in. If he doesn't find another taunt and this Aldor dies, combo is basically sealing it. So
Savage Roar, but then
have we seen a Savage Roar burn yet? We've not, right?
No, not one.
Not
there's
yet.
Still two in the deck.
But you're gonna have to do something about this, JJ.
Well, combo is not lethal next turn because he will not have the mana.
Right, so I'm assuming Dr. Boom just is an all-in, and the only thing is that there's a good argument for Truesilver for one reason. You heal to 16 over two turns. And healing to 16 means you're out of combo range.
What's the best card now? You need to deal with the taunt. Are you dead next turn? 6, 9, 15, 19.
19, yeah.
You are actually dead.
Yeah.
And Raptor is not changing the fact that you're dead.
Yeah, if he plays Raptor, yeah, he's just dead, isn't he? So he just has to Force of Nature.
But Force of Nature is your only
You would never do that, yeah.
And Paladin normally doesn't do burst. So you have to hope that Paladin actually can't kill you.
Alright, so we're looking at the lethal for JJ.
Quickly count the damage. 9, 6, 15, plus 4, 19. Counting twice, just in case. Counting third time. Alright, you got it after three tries.
It's good.
Yeah, it's enough.
Third time's the charm, and he's gonna win. Is he gonna BM the owl on the Fell Reaver? It looks like he did, right? Yep, he did. Happy Feast of Winterfell!
Oh, baby!
I love you, JJ. You are my soulmate.
He's the best.
He's trying to tilt his opponent just enough that it wins the game mentally.
It's just nice. He's just a friendly.
Yeah. There are no secrets, no Christmas tree yet. Happy Feast of Winterfell.
That's the best emote ever. I love it.
Yeah, they need to keep something like that every time.
Yeah.
But the thing is, how many times will they bring the voice actors in the studio?
Well, they can do it once and then just rehash it every year.
Well, that's fine, but that's a lot. Like, you have to be... If they bring them in, they have to literally do those emotes for the entire year. So they must have all the sound files already, right?
Oh, is it also for Alleria, Magni?
Yeah, I tried with Magni.
Okay.
He's pretty kind.
Nice.
Yeah. So,
no surprise, Rogue from Legendaeren to deal with this Paladin.
Yeah, but the Paladin's curving. And the Rogue doesn't have any broken preps.
And Harrison.
That's true, but this matchup overall is so good.
Yeah, Harrison Jones.
Harrison is a big card here. Interesting. But this is last hero standing for you guys. So we do have those counter decks to counter specific matchups. And that's exactly what happened. But the first win was important.
So here's the deal. What if JJ wins? I mean, loses, sorry. The Rogue wins. Druid comes out from JJ, deals the same thing to his opponent as his opponent's Druid did to him. And then it boils down to one last deck with Malilock. Malilock takes it. Malilock versus the Druid. Like, how does that go down?
That's all right. That's an okay matchup because you have really good minions and you can just win overpowering the board.
Okay.
Yeah, you definitely need the ramp, though, if you're the Druid, to stand a chance.
Exactly.
You need to even just one Wild Growth or something. Something to just get a little bit more ahead.
So, if you're JJ, next turn is pretty dry. Do you ever silence your zombie chow?
No.
It's just to build up...
Because imagine that. If the Rogue's attacking here, she's setting up Fan of Knives. She's hoping to get that 5 health back. Now you're dealing 6 with the Zombie Chow alone.
You are, but I don't like Silence here because you have to play versus.
You could play Keeper, right?
Keeper onto the Zombie Chow.
On the Chow, yeah.
Yeah, Keeper is fine here.
So the Chow not being owled is all right. So long as...
We didn't get the Owl Chow play.
It is pretty solid. Man, Super JJ must feel good about that. That 3-3 just feels so good.
It does, yeah. It's a good zombie. And he is the beatdown. He recognizes that. This matchup is so bad that he has to be aggressive.
And Legendaeren's still not drawn into a deadly poison, which is going to be pretty key. Because he has the flurry, but he can't quite squeeze in the oil either, so...
Yeah, Fan of Knives Recycle looks pretty sweet. Unless you decide to go for a re-dagger turn.
What about Farseer?
Farseer, the issue with that is that if there's a Truesilver, you're not doing anything. And you're still getting, you know, taking another 8.
If there is no Truesilver then, you do heal yourself for free and you have a minion that will be able to trade into something.
Do you mind a Tinkers and then Flurry next turn? Just like casually pass it and just set up the wipe? That's very, very liberal with the resources. But could that be what he needs to do?
It's fine, I think, because you will still be able to find out knives after Flurry.
Man, that Harrison Jones, he gets the message. But the owl has to be used on that shell. Come on, man. You can't not.
It actually seems like a good play.
You actually have to. It's so powerful.
Because your opponent is at 13 already.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ah, well.
Not today.
The Flurry takes out the entire turn, followed by the Farseer. So again, that setup was amazing. Now back to 21 for the Rogue player.
And it's huge, because Paladin normally doesn't have Burst. So the game is reset, and it's back to Rogueland.
Yeah, where they basically do what they want.
Yeah.
And now the Muster for Battle is useless, because Fan of Knives may come up at any point.
Harrison Jones is useless as well.
For the time being, yeah. And it's going to take a while, I think, before Legendaeren wants to redagger.
Would you ever play Harrison Jones there? Because it is the biggest minion you can play. It does come to...
Probably not going to get sapped.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's be honest. It's going to eat an Eviscerate at the least.
Dr. Boom as well. Oh, man.
Yeah. I guess the silencing the zombie chow was initially worth it. I just feel like the Rogue at 15 is starting to be afraid of anything you play. I'm not sure if that's worth it, though.
Well, we've seen Rogue actually go down to like 6 or 8 versus Paladins and Priests, and it still wins.
Yeah. So you'd have to find... I think if you had a Truesilver champion in hand, you may do it.
Yeah.
Just because all of a sudden...
8 damage per.
Right, exactly. You have the phase damage. And now the Harrison will remove the dagger up play that Legendaeren was planning for with the Deadly. And that 5-4 is really annoying.
I mean, you can play.
Oh, never
you can
mind.
Play Belcher Abyss anyway, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Or Lothab Abyss, you know.
Dr. Boom Abyss.
Dr. Boom Abyss, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, that's pretty okay.
Solid.
As it turns a good out, card, right?
I think so. Heard that
it's
somewhere.
Okay.
That's one good tempo play.
Guess right. I'll run 2 preps in Rogue.
So you can wipe everything but the Dr. Boom if you attack into the Farseer. Let's just hope for your sake, though, that you're not going to be taking 8 from these Boombots.
Troll Boombots, and that's a 2 and...
5 damage.
It's still a lot. It's still a lot.
It is, but you have Lay on Hands at the very least. If Lothab doesn't get played, and if it does get played, then, well, you're out of luck.
Yeah, I mean, there's no reason not to Lothab this turn.
You right? can even dagger up and deadly and go face. Yeah. That's 4 damage to face, which means it's 8. So next turn you just win with Lothab.
And you have Sap for Tyrion.
That's right.
Yeah.
So
he's got to play the Lothab if he's playing any minion.
I like Deadly Poison going phase as well, yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing.
You can basically set up lethal and whatever. You can't lay on hands.
A heal bot, I guess, is the only thing that, right?
There may be a Tusk or Jouster as well. Oh, Belcher looks like a saving grace for SuperJJ.
There is a Sap still.
Right. You could also, I guess, use the Keeper on the Lothab to trade. And then play the Murloc Knight. That may save you. I think that's the
That's probably
best
the
option.
Yeah, that's probably the play, but then...
Do you make that play in JJ's position, though?
I mean, you can't lay on hands. What's the alternative? You play Belcher, you get sapped. He knows how rogues do it, and he just saw Lothab, which means Rogue is ready to sap you and win the game right away.
Yeah.
He knows it. He's played way too much of that class.
Exactly. He is the Rogue player himself. So this is so amazing that we talk about this plays, we analyze them, we argue about them, and then JJ actually makes the best play.
Yeah, and look at that now. He's 1 off lethal, right? He's got a total of, actually no, 2 off lethal even.
Yeah.
So just based on that, SuperJJ gets to use Lay on Hands, gets to trade his board into whatever Legendaeren's playing. He's got card advantage after that play, gets the Zombie Chow, maybe finds himself another minion to heal up, like a Healbot, or a Truesilver even. So, good spot.
Yeah. So do you just go all in here? Or do you kill the 3-4? Because 3-4 will be annoying, and if you play Belcher and SI, you still have really good...
I would probably go Belcher, SI to face, right? You've seen the equality early. Yeah. I mean, the Consecration, right? Sorry. And
do you not want to try and get the Thanos down? Because you kind of want the card draw, right?
I don't mind that, but you're not re-daggering. I guess the card draw may be worth more since you get the SI's damage.
You have so
anyway.
Much mana next turn and no cards,
that's
then
true.
You can just re-dagger next turn.
Good point. He opts for the SI, but I can totally see where he's coming from with that play, though.
Yeah.
Like, it's not as though it somehow doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it's not. Either play wasn't bad.
And now that makes Lay on Hands a bit clunky because you don't remove any damage from the board. If anything, you're mitigating some of it.
you'll have to run both minions to belch possibly.
Coghammer is a great card.
Can JJ actually stabilize? There's so many cards that just win the game here. There's 4, 5, 8 damage.
It's only 8 on board, man.
It's well, Abyssir, it still wins.
Well, yeah, but it's Rapid very it's know. One card. The Oil, he's already played early. Flurry doesn't win. I mean, it kind of does by procuration, because next turn you win.
Yeah.
But.
And he can't even kill his own Thanos to draw.
What a shame. And now he's making a trade. Because he doesn't want to see any Murlocs. And the double Belcher from JJ means you better have 2 saps or a really good Flurry, because you're going to get roadblocked, followed by the Coghammer.
Yeah, this is time to trade.
Awkward one, but at the same time, can you really push on a board like this one?
If JJ wins this game, this would be so amazing.
I think JJ is on his way to the win, unless things go really awful. I
mean, what has to come out from Legendaeren? Sprint?
It has to be a second sap top deck would really help, but like a prep sprint into another sap, into whatever else he needs.
The best part is that second sap doesn't actually win the game.
Right? Well, from the prep sprint, I mean, you have to pick up a sprint in order to get the sap.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you can't find it and win. Oh man, this is amazing.
And you go for double Belcher. Is there anything better?
Nah, I think playing anything else. I mean, I guess you could technically Coghammer, play the Juggler, and then Belch.
Yeah.
Because that way you get the extra. I love that play here. The silence on the Thalnos.
Yeah, just deny the card draw.
Insane. He spots.
Really good insight there. Yeah.
He knows what he's hoping for when he plays Rogue.
Exactly.
Oh
man.
This was the card we were talking about.
Yeah, but this is the card he needed to actually stabilize. It was looking really bad for Legendaeren.
He picks up the Abyss and the Flurry.
Okay, what so?
You gotta, you can't, if you sap now, you're missing out, right?
Yeah, you don't sap here.
Do you just...
Does he have to Flurry though? Nah,
it feels
actually,
awful.
It's Flurry and Abyss. Do you have to wait till next turn?
Can you just pass? Because next
Drake, Flurry, Abyss.
Yeah, Drake, Flurry, Abyss is lethal.
It's lethal next turn, yeah, if there's no more healing. And you're not going to die. No way. Yeah, there's no way you die right here.
I think you do pass, because anything else doesn't do enough.
Man, well,
you can sap Belcher for fun.
Yeah, yeah, true.
You might as well. You might as well, actually, because then if he wants to replay it, he may not be able to play another... Now the Drake.
Oh, he just draws another Drake.
She's just got another Drake.
Oh my god.
Oh no.
He still has
it's
it.
Okay playing Drake when you know you're going to draw
it. Silver Champion would help a lot. That is not it.
And that's it. That's so much damage with the second Naja Drake. That's lethal.
Yeah, without a True Silver Champion to heal up just above.
But to be honest, it was a one-sided match.
It did look like JJ should have lost.
It always looks like this, right? The Paladin or Priest are trying to claw back. It's like, I almost have you, Rogue. And then you just get backstabbed.
Yeah. A bit like real life.
Yep. Tough. And JJ is doing whatever he can, but he knows that after that sprint, there's so many cards to kill him. Just refusing to play Tyrion. You're not sapping my Tyrion this game, Legendaeren.
Yeah, well, I think Legendaeren, I mean, he might, could he ever brain fart? No, okay, never mind, he just goes directly
I spoke to Legendaeren earlier, before this match, and you know he missed his lethal earlier with the Malagos?
He realized it?
He realized it as soon as he played the dragon.
Oh.
He played the dragon, was like, oh. So I think after that, as I think Lothar might have mentioned, like, he will be counting every single turn now to ensure that he doesn't miss lethal again, because he's like, yeah, I missed it on stream. And it's like, yeah, but you played well overall. You missed it.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter, I missed lethal on stream. So it's like, he isn't going to repeat that
mistake.
You're
not very forgiving.
Never forget.
Yeah, people saw me miss lethal. This is worst case scenario. It doesn't matter that I won.
Yeah.
But RDU's like that as well, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And JJ as well. JJ really wants to play a game all the time, and if he makes a mistake, he will actually feel really bad about himself.
Yeah. I saw no mistakes from JJ during those games. I feel like he's played all his games really flawlessly. But the Rogue has been really on point with the like the tempo they get. Now, JJ is going to try his Druid. It's his last chance. He has to beat the Rogue and the Malagos Warlock back to back with this deck.
He still has an okay chance to do it. I think the matches are closer to 50-50 than one of like Rogue or Malagos being super good versus.
True.
And Druid is Druid.
And then also, you know, the laser going onto the rogue there from, I'm guessing, production.
Yeah.
Trying to burn down Legendaeren.
Oh, no, that's not production. That's absolutely Super JJ.
Oh, is that? Oh, that's JJ's screen, right? It's not a spectator. Oh, yeah. Of course. So JJ's actually just trying to take a few points of damage from the rogue.
One thing to say, too, is Dr. Boom, the single most important card against rogues to play as early as possible, if you're able to, because they literally do not want to sap it. But
is Dr. Boom one of the best cards to play early versus anyone?
No, I think versus Rogue it's especially painful. It's like Rag, right? Pay
attention, class. It would be so funny if, with the laser, if you point it to the face.
Enough
once,
times.
Once in like million times, it will actually deal one damage. And we will feel so awkward if it happens in a major tournament.
Yeah. You could time it so it looks that way. And then you look really, like, clever.
Yeah, very smart.
It's kind of like the secret trick.
So what is going on here? 5 mana is pretty good. He has the Wrath. He can't really deal with...
he could deal 3 damage to it, finish off the 1-1, then keep her on the next turn, and then kill the other 1-1 that spawns with the hero power number 2.
That's alright. That's alright.
But one thing to keep in mind as well is that Legendaeren on turn 4 has nothing to do. He may just have the Fan of Knives, nothing.
Which is okay. He will get the token from it.
But that plays right into Super JJ's game plan.
It's trap.
I think versus Druid, though, it might still be okay to fan, because it's not often you get good a good fan of knives off versus Druid. He does just slam the SI, though, so...
Yeah, that's good for
playing around JJ. Playing around what JJ is trying to do here.
No, man, if you get something like Preparation... Even though Keeper of the Grove is actually...
Look at that. Wrath, Keeper, and then Dr. Boom as the follow-up. Looking not too bad. However, the Dr. Boom does die to Fan of Knives Eviscerate, or on Backstab, even. Unless...
You can use Backstab here, because you want to keep Drake. And still, Fan of Knives, Eviscerate kills Dr. Boom. Unless.
Unless. Indeed, unless.
It's always unless. The Boom bots.
There is always an unless. And JJ recognizes the strength of Dr. Boom against Rogues, and he's hoping that he's going to be able to get the kill off of it. But based on this hand from Legendaeren, that's not happening.
Do you double Evis?
You can't.
Be safe,
you can't,
and then Thanos?
You can't actually mess it up. You can Fan of Knives. If it dies, then I guess worst case scenario, you just kill it next turn.
Sweet, but if he uses Evis into Evis.
Well, sure. You can,
just it's safe versus safe.
You can go Thanos. You can go, I guess.
Yeah, Thanos, Evis, Evis.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, unfortunately, you can
you can't even
Thanos
dagger and take it.
If you, so it would be so funny if he like attacks face with the Drake, then Fan of Knives, and then it's like, oh, my Drake actually died, and you play Thanos and you finish with Evis. But he doesn't have mana for that.
Yeah, he's one mana off. But what if the Drake dies now?
Ooh.
What?
Oh! 8!
Whoa! JJ!
JJ!
That victory dance!
Whoa!
Oh, baby!
Legendaeren!
You know what was legendary? Those bombs!
And the ancient of lore for card draw for JJ, picking up another threat.
The bomb just survived.
Unbelievable!
What?
Oh no!
Oh my god, what
and JJ
happened?
Gets 7 damage for free, putting his opponent on combo range. Any force of nature is going to be a win, but right now we can see Legendaeren is able to play 2 of his raids to wipe the board and
wow.
Reset it.
Yeah, the
but force
massive.
Of nature, man, force of nature top deck is good game at any point.
It is, and well, he has this Sludge Belcher. Force of Nature now is actually ending the game, but after Sludge Belcher, he might have a chance.
Oh,
if this
go.
Is force of nature, this will be hilarious. Ah, oh, it's not.
Could be a swipe. Oh man. Okay, so what about just Shade on the next turn?
Well, you want to draw Force.
Yeah, he has to draw. He has to try to find Force of Nature. There's no way he doesn't. He has seen the 2 Eviscerates. So
yeah.
The only thing that burns him is oil.
And this means like Legendaeren cannot play Dr. Boom after this. You just have to play Belcher and have to trade as well. But can you really trade here?
You have to trade.
But then
you die.
Can't spend 2 minions.
If you do not trade...
You not just trade with FaZe.
Can you?
Well, you save versus Belcher on an empty board, right?
You take 5 damage, you will have 8.
He would need, like, Innovate double force, double Savage, right?
Okay.
I think, to go through.
Even Innervate hero power is enough. Like, just...
On.
You could just...
Yeah.
No, you don't even need the second roar, yeah. Right? Just the one.
I think at this point, if Legendaeren wants to win, he can't put both minions into it.
Okay, so he has to use his face and get
I
down
so,
to
yeah.
8 health. And if there's double swipe, too bad.
Yeah.
All right. Plays with Thalnos, gets more minions in, and he's shoving.
This
is,
okay.
This is intense.
This works as well.
Force of Nature is lethal.
Force of Nature. Ooh. That is not a Force of Nature.
Wild Growth could draw one card, but it can't be the win. So if he does go for the Wild Growth...
Can JJ survive here?
I think JJ may go for Jewel of the Claw Shade with Darnassus or Hero Power, depending. And you can damage the Belcher, you know, start clawing at it a bit. Taunting up is good. If there's no sap, you're protected. So you basically save 6 damage.
There are 2 cards in hand. There will be 3.
Yeah.
And more you'd run Thanos and the Sludge into the Druid of the Claw as well as one of the 4/4s.
Wow.
To draw an additional card as well.
What a tense moment.
Legendaeren actually has 2 spell damage. This means Flurry is dealing just 3. Like
yeah,
3 damage.
Baseline, yeah. It's like a Phantom of Knowledge for 3. It's pretty nuts.
Phantom of Knowledge.
Whoa, 3 damage on Living Roots.
Doesn't change anything, though, I don't think.
It does let you remove the Thalnos for all that's worth. I don't think that's worth very much. You're probably going to go for Jewel of the Claw in a position like this one with no alternative and just pray there's no sap and something like a Flurry. Oh, man.
Jewel of the Claw to taunt, yeah.
Do it,
you don't want to. You don't want to die here.
What does Legendaeren find? A sap! Wow.
Well, it's not over yet.
No, but it's so close.
Yes, and he can sap and play Dr. Boom if he wants.
He has to make trades, though. Right?
Can he actually get something for Thalnos to just win right here?
Yeah, Flurry.
Yeah, I think
it's worth trading Thalnos in.
Is Deadly Poison lethal? Then, yeah.
Yeah, it's actually just
one off.
A little shy. Well, I mean, yeah, you do have to find the deadly.
Well, he can sap the Druid of the Claw.
One off.
Run the 2/1s, or the 1-attack minions into the 5/2. And then just trade a 4/4 if he needs to, depending on what Thanos draws.
We'll have to see what Legendaeren. We know for a fact that if he's going for sap, there's no Violet Teacher coming out. So it's got to be. He's checking.
All right, he's trying to get lethal, and that's 2 damage, so it's 10.
He's one off 12. Again. One off.
Should he not have sapped first, though? I mean, he can SI anyway. And this keeps the sludge alive.
The little slime is alive, but Force of Nature is still lethal. JJ's praying that nothing goes wrong.
The stress is incredible for JJ.
I mean, think about that. The Living Roots really helps here, though, if you need to clean up that slime at any point.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it's really necessary at the moment.
Yeah, Force Nature isn't lethal anymore because of the sludge.
It is. The Living Roots.
The Living Roots, of course. Oh man, never Force of Nature.
So if you play the Druid of the Claw in taunt mode, that's 6 damage you're mitigating. You use Living Roots to kill something, Keeper of the Grove to kill something.
And you still survive if there is no top deck.
Yeah, exactly. You have to do it.
And Force of Nature is still lethal. You might actually develop Shade as well, if possible.
No, you can't. You have to play the Keeper to kill that 1-1 and that 1-2.
All right. You're right.
Oh, man. This is so stressful. I'm not even playing and I'm stressed out.
How is it those close again?
What an intense. He's going to kill the Drake with those two.
Spell damage is good, yeah.
Good idea there. So.
So 8-9 damage if there is a sap. Sap finishes the game.
Oh my god.
Blank.
What a bad draw for Legendaeren.
But this game is not over. JJ still doesn't have lethal.
There's a BGH.
He still needs force of nature.
The thing is as well, though, every turn that JJ's not drawing force means he's more and more likely to draw it. He's gone so far into his deck.
Yeah.
He's still not drawing it.
How good of a Jedi is he? Can he trust the force?
I don't know. What a dank joke. Oh, goodness. So you have the BGH for the Dr. Boom in this case. So SuperJJ is going to be able to stall a bit longer. If he picks up a swipe off the top, I think he's in a really good shape.
Well, Force wins this.
Well, of course.
What else? Is Savager winning this as well? Not really.
No.
Druid of the Claw, is Druid of the Claw winning this?
Well, it taunts up, so it's amazing, yeah.
Oh, I got
wow, Wild Growth. You have to Wild Growth. Find a swipe.
Because if he doesn't find a swipe, is he dead?
Druid of the Claw would actually work because he can BGH and then Druid.
Oh wow, there is a swipe.
But might he die?
Oh, the bombs.
So you have to BGH first.
BGH first. Protect yourself.
Oh no.
This is clear lethal for Legendaeren. What's
worse is JJ did the dance about his bombs. Is Legendaeren going to do the dance about these?
Legendaeren doesn't even need 8 to face. It's just 5.
Yeah, he needs 4 even because the dagger's up.
You're right.
Four to face.
Oh man, the bombs. Can he play anything else now? This is the very important moment.
Oh my god.
The Legendaeren is praying. Where the bombs landing? Not yet.
And the draw.
Nothing. And the 4-2 lives, which means Savage Roar.
is plus five.
It's lethal.
That's lethal.
Yes, that's lethal.
Yeah, no, it's healed.
There's a heal. Force.
But now he's mitigating the dagger hit.
Druid of the Claw Force. What else? Another keeper? Is it possible?
I don't even care. Anything that doesn't.
Anything.
Something.
Oh, double man. Shredder armor up. Make that trade. And then.
Do you play the aspirant as well?
And no.
Innovate armor up?
It doesn't matter. You're either dead on the top deck or you win.
You have to.
There is absolutely.
Yeah, there's no way, right? Yeah.
Oh my god.
So if this is SI.
No, wait. You have to armor up because Flurry, right? Flurry would be the one.
Deadly Poison's lethal.
Flurry is not lethal because Carver up is not up.
Unbelievable!
Legendaeren is like, dude, like this.
Oh man.
And he can't do anything, right? This is lethal for JJ because he has Savage Roar.
And no force of nature was necessary, but it took
a long time.
Took ages.
Happy feast of Winterfell! No! Oh, the feast.
Oh, man, he's just going for it. Then JJ ties the series. They're going to
Unbelievable.
Warlock.
That was an amazing game. You know, this feels like two snails just running after each other until one of them trips on a branch, like a tiny little speck of dust, and the other one's like, gotcha. Like, it wasn't even satisfying. It's just hilarious. Oh, all right. Well, the ramp is there for Super JJ here, and he's got the keeper for the Twilight Drake.
Yeah, that's a good opening for JJ and the Druid of the Claw as well. Dark Peddler.
We're losing all our caster composure here. We're not even casting anymore. We're just screaming.
Just laughing at it. Dude, this is pure Hearthstone. I love it.
I'm loving this so far. Oh, the Dark Bomb, though, will put a dent in Super JJ's ability to get the ramp going, so he might just opt not to coin because it's scary.
Because it's scary.
It is scary.
Double Bigam Hunter is not what you want to see.
Yeah, and the peddler options were Lepinome, Voidwalker, and the Grimscale Oracle, right? That was that 1-1 there.
I haven't seen it, but
yeah.
The 1-1 Murloc, that plus one attack is Grimscale. Yeah.
This is a pretty good turn. I mean, Super JJ, sure, he's not going to be able to keep his ramp, but he will see the one drop from Legendaeren and not worry about Power Overwhelmings or Soulfires all game long. And he will be able to kill the 2-2 with the Keeper, or maybe just, you know, play what he just drew.
Yeah, Shredder is nice. Because if you play Shade, you probably don't want to use the Shade this early. And with Power Shredder, you can start contesting this board. And
yeah, but Legendaeren's almost certainly going to follow up with Implosion.
If it misses, though.
And it's pretty damage,
just
pretty good.
About, right? Oh, and the 1-1 as
great
well.
Great Legendaeren.
Yeah, pretty bad outcome there for JJ, but what goes around comes around.
Eventually, as we saw in the last game.
Is he waiting on a swipe?
No dragons. Do you go for it? Swipe is pretty good here. You might still just stop and play Bran, actually.
I mean, if you play Bran, you're playing the swipe even harder. The question is, how much do you care?
I would probably like my Bran being swiped and my Blackwing Raptor, and I would love to play Blackwing Raptor after swipe.
Yeah.
Blackwing Raptor also, like, you really want to have the dragon to deal that 3 points of damage. This is what matters.
Yeah, and he did pick the Malygos up, which is going to stay there for the entire game. So I swear to God, right now, Super JJ is beat down. He's getting beat down, that is, really hard. A lot more unusual than you'd expect.
Yeah, this is exactly what I said with Malygos versus Druid. If Malygos has good opening with minions, it feels like you're playing versus two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, and now the...
You have to charge, right?
And with the Corruptor next turn, because of the Malygos draw, this Druid of the Claw doesn't look so scary anymore.
You have to charge to kill Bran if you play Druid of the Claw. Otherwise, you play the Keeper of the Grove to kill the Peddler.
Yeah.
But you cannot just taunt up. Otherwise, you just...
Ooh.
Well, that's...
Ouch.
There's a painful Blackwing Raptor for 6 damage because of Bran Bronzebeard.
Better pick up a swipe, my friend.
And even using the 1-1s to trade in to negate a potential swipe follow-up is really nice there.
Legendaeren has time. He has a good board, he has time. He doesn't have to rush this game. When Druid is behind, it's really hard to come back. He's trying to get that swipe at some point.
Innervates the Shade out, so he's getting a board, but... I mean, even if he heals up, where are we looking at? 7, 8, 9, 10 damage. A Soulfire would almost be the game. And the Twilight Guardian is really tough to go through. If you want to go for Emperor, feel free to do
yeah,
so.
Yeah, would you not just Twilight Guardian play him gang boss?
Yeah.
Throw everything on the board and say you have to deal with the whole board or you are going to
The thing is, this is very weak to swipe.
Yeah, how important it is to actually kill the Azure Drake?
Because it would be weak to swipe if you went for that Twilight Guardian play, so maybe you're considering...
Yeah, you could trade the 2-4 and the 2-2 in to the Drake, I guess.
I mean, look at the size of this Twilight. Like, this thing is growing.
Yeah, 4 attack now.
Yeah, that's very tough. I think
now you've got to guess like Brand's probably, you know, had his use now. If you throw him and the peddler away into the Drake, you still hit for 6 this turn.
Yeah, there's nothing the Druid can do here to really push you off, right?
Yeah.
I can't even think of a thing. I think the core moment here was the Druid of the Claw not killing the Brand, and instead going into taunt mode, which basically surrendered any possibility of getting the tempo back in your favor.
Yeah, and now with other swipe. This looks really bad.
You could silence the Twilight Guardian, negate some of the incoming damage, but
there's so 7-8 damage coming. So JJ concedes, and Legendaeren is the first finalist.
And that's basically what we kind of hoped for overall, right? Seeing locals win, it's kind of nice to see that we have a UK player in the finals. At least.
He is UK? Not really UK.
Well, he's not.
He's playing for London Conspiracy.
He's playing for London Conspiracy, but, you know.
Yeah.
It's an ex friend.
I'm happy to see. Yeah.
He fights for UK.
Well, he fights for himself as well, and he is the first finalist. He is the rogue.
Okay, sure.
Come on, Noxious. He did really well.
Yeah.
And JJ did great as well, just qualifying for the qualifier being here. But Legendaeren did qualify himself. He wasn't invited. He won versus JJ. He's the first finalist playing a really cool lists because an aggressive Druid is interesting. Maligos lock. This is one of few Maligos locks in the tournament because
we had a few,
but I feel like Reno lock was more popular.
Not true. That's actually true. We saw a lot more Reno. I think we saw a good split of both, but most of the ones that went through or it seemed to do better were the Reno type.
Yeah, and Maligos lock was the most important deck at DreamHack Winter, where Purple actually won of it. Legendaeren bringing it and being in the final again with that deck. And you know, with Rogue as well. So Rogue we identified as one of the best classes in this tournament so far because most of the Rogues actually made it to the top 8.
Yeah, and in that set, just the first match again was so important. The Druid versus the Rogue, and being able to just take that win, take Rogue off SuperJJ, and then the rest just slotted into place for Legendaeren there. So, crazy set overall. Definitely one of the most tense games I cast, the actual match before the last one.
Yeah.
Every top deck from either player had to be blank for this to go on so long. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. So Legendaeren first, finalist, and then we will have to decide who's next. Visual. Or RDU. This is the next match, guys. And this is going to be intense as well.
We'll get Lothar back on the casting bench to supervise his teammate.
Yeah, absolutely. Lothar is always having good feedback when his guys are playing and when he's playing. All right, so this was the first semifinal. We have one more for you and then obviously the grand final. This is Insomnia True Silver Championship. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more Hearthstone after a short break.